Right. Well, this is about back to Felix and Felix V, the antipope, and his 10-year duration there. It was 10 years plus after, you know, the people's minds, maybe 15. But what happened at the end of his reign is he was given 5 knights that lived with him in this quasi-monastic state for the duration of his life. Okay, so they have the knights, 5 knights clunking around there. And that was odd to me. It seems like an odd thing to have 5 knights all the way through the end of your life. That they're your watchdogs, you know. I know he was the Pope, but it just seemed odd, you know. And so I'm going all over in my mind, well, what is it? You know, what is going on here? It seems like maybe there's something, some money. Maybe there's money that they were guarding also, you know, a bounty of riches and wealth that had been acquired during the time of his reign as Pope. So it could be that they have like a, you know, gathered quite a bit of riches. And then I'm like, well, that's possible. That's very possible, because you have the break off, this great schism happening, and then the break off of Rome, and they're like, well, this is our chance to maybe collect a little. And so there they are collecting, and so maybe that's what it is. That's what the 5 knights were all about, was keeping the bounty that they had scored upon, essentially. So that's kind of interesting, but so Felix, what else did I have to say about him? That was really it. It was just why such a short reign, also only 10 years, and then off to have the knights, there as your keeper, your watchers, your helpers. Why only the 10 years? And so if it was such a short time, were they doing something there with banking? Were they doing something like creating a code, something different from Rome, something that was different from the other papalcy, something that was nothing to do with any church state of Italy or France? Something that was just a keep, a hold, specifically for Switzerland, Austria, and parts of Germany. So it seems very, very intriguing now. I'm like, well, if these guys were there, maybe they were creating a code, you know, like a banking code, special cryptography, something that was theirs, that was unique, that had nothing to do with Rome. So that at any point in time, or Avignon, because they had moved to Avignon also. So at any time in the near future, they could always have some kind of a fallback state, or if not a fallback state, a way of keeping the money. Because if you think about the money collection that comes in from the tithings, the money that comes in from the patrons of the churches, you know, maybe there was a sifting routine that they created, that even if it was a Roman church, I didn't care. Maybe they created a sifting routine, so more of it was held there in Switzerland than Rome would ever see. More was held in Switzerland than the Avignon French would ever see. So it's almost like now we have to have this Pope. You start to look at it like maybe now we need to have this Pope. We need to fatten up our coffs. make sure the money is there, and not feel taken or had by Rome, by money going south or money going over to France, and so on. So I guess you understand what I'm trying to say there. Unfortunately, this video is acting up. I don't know if it'll work out. But anyway, and I guess I was trying to clarify also, back to me leaving Switzerland. I was not kicked out or anything. It was that one of the reasons was, though, they did not allow me to get married there. And it was very odd that they said American citizen, even though I worked there under contract, I had to go back to United States soil and get married there. And I, you know, it just threw me for a loop, you know. Anyway. This had nothing to do with the Opera House. This is just their rules of engagement with any, at the time, with any Americans. They forced you to head back to America for marriage papers. It was very, very, very strange. Yeah. Had to be a citizen, had to have some kind of long durée there, and I guess I did not have that much time. Anyway, so that's all. That's all. So the money is there. The knights are still marching around in their ghost selves, clunking around, knowing where they've stashed it, and Pope Amadeus Felix V. You know, maybe it was a collector moment, you know, it was just a collector from the patrons, you know, just get our cash only and build for a while, and then devise a routine for the cash that was heading south, or was heading to Avignon. But yeah, anyway, I know, that's it. That is all. Yeah, don't burn your jade plants like I did. Gosh, dang it. Don't leave them in the hot sun. And that's that.